Welcome back to TAGATA PASIFIKA. As winter begins to bite, many families are feeling the pinch, and among the biggest concerns is, will they be able to keep a roof over their heads? In Auckland, where rents are high and house prices are out of reach, many Pasifika families are struggling to make ends meet. John Utanga has this story.
It's a cool night in West Auckland.
My parents sleep in the lounge. Sometimes we all just sleep in the lounge.
Young mother Saini Namai has just finished work. She lives in this two-bedroom flat with her three young children, her parents and some relatives, nine people in all.
I would like my kids to have their own space. My sister, she goes to school. I can see that she's finding it hard to study. She'll either squash here with us while all our beds are all on the ground.
And then there's the cold and damp.
It worries me very much because my daughter, she has a history with bronchitis. She's been hospitalised like twice, three times a year.
Saini's been trying to find a bigger place to live, but with Auckland's housing shortage and the family's limited income, it's just impossible.
When I tell them the amount of people I have, it's a completely no from them. They won't take it. It's too many people.
The family's housing problems have come to the attention of the Whanau Health and Social Service in Henderson. They say the family's plight is typical of many in their area.
So we have an asthma specialist nurse downstairs, and for years we've looked at the increase in the number of asthma. When we look so deeper into it, it's actually all related to housing. Cold, damp housing that actually cause all the asthma, but also wider health issues.
The Whanau says housing remains an uphill battle for many Pacific families.
83% of our Pacific people in West Auckland live in the three most deprived areas. And trying to move them into better housing, it continues to be the challenge.
Across town in South Auckland, Tongan community leader Salote Lilo says it's much the same in her area.
Big time struggling, and some of them, when the house is too cold and they can't afford to buy heaters and that, they go spend the night or the week with sisters or brothers.
Government's solution to Auckland's housing problem is to free up land to build more houses. But Lilo says people need solutions for now.
They looked into 2020. Get real. Let's deal with that. 2015, let's deal with the fact now. Don't wait until my grandma passed away or my children died because of illness. Let's get on to it, and I urge the government, do it now.
Meanwhile, the Namaya family in West Auckland continues to struggle on to make the best of their situation.
It's our home. It may be small, but it's our home. We're happy as we are. I'm with my family. That's all that matters.
Well, joining me now to talk more about this issue is Elaine Lawless-Seal, the housing manager from Auntie Cecilia Housing Trust. Welcome, Elaine, to our show. Now, first of all, it's a very big issue, housing, but how serious is it for our Pacific people?
We have a housing crisis in Auckland, and many of our Pacifica people are struggling in garages, overcrowded conditions, and some of them are pulled up to Auntie Cecilia House in a car.
Right, so with Monte Cecilia, your emergency housing, how many families can you cater for and house in your trust?
At one time, we have 12 families living in residence with 65 men, women and children that are in our doors at the moment. They need a house. 12 families this morning, they are needing a home of their own.
Well, so I imagine you'd have to turn a lot of families away, right?
We have a queue that comes out, goes into our offices, and we're not able to help those families. We hear of their plights, we experience a lot of what they're saying, and it is just overwhelming for the families, and it's very heartbreaking for us when we are not able to find a housing solution.
Okay, incredibly tough job. How do you decide which families get temporary housing and who doesn't?
It's really about the children. We have a focus on our children. They are the future of our generation, and we would like to see them housed in safe, warm, affordable rentals.
Right, so those unfortunate lot that you have to turn away, what options do they have?
They will remain where they are in South Auckland. We have a lot of boarding houses that are very undesirable and very hard for these families to manage and cope. So they remain where they are in those garages that are cold, drafty and very wet at the moment.
Right, now, what's contributing to the situation? We've got the house prices, but also the rents are too high. Is this what's magnifying the issue?
For a lot of our low-income Pacifica families, they struggle to find a private rental that is affordable. They are discriminated, and for many of them, they will remain in those garages until a solution is found. Many of those families find that solution with Monte Cecilia House.
Wow, and great job. Now, you mentioned earlier the conditions of the homes that people are living in, and we've seen earlier this week with the death of that two-year-old child. I mean, are you seeing many more cases where the accommodation is not insulated, it's damp? I mean, what types of...
Every day I experience families calling us from where they are, and it is damp, it's cold, and they sometimes have to be in their cars where they pull up in a park, have a wash, get back in, take their kids to school.
So what more can be done for this situation?
We need more affordable rentals. We need more state houses. We need more housing for our low-income families.
Well, the government did announce some relief from the budget. Do you think that that's going to be enough to make a difference?
We have 12 families that are waiting and are desperate for housing.
And many more, I imagine. How big is the increase in the last year, have you seen?
Well, we also have just under 30 houses from South Auckland to West Auckland. We have a satellite, Monte Cecilia, where we're hearing a lot more experiences. And for some of our families, they work in West Auckland. We've provided them accommodation in South. It is a struggle commuting anywhere in that side.
I guess finally, we still have Pacific people who are wanting to move to New Zealand. What would your advice be to them? Is New Zealand still the land of milk and honey?
Well, I believe it's still that dream, because many of our families come in the hope that they have better education for their children, a better income bracket. It just takes time.
Okay. Thank you so much, Elaine, for joining us today. Now, let us know what you think on Facebook or Twitter, but stay with us, because after the break, artist-musician Coco Solid.
I think it has a huge significance being a Pacific Music Award, me being a Pacific person, but this for me is a different level of recognition because it has a lot of soul to it. I don't take them to find in me.